Well, it's the weekend again. Agent Jay-Z here, on location, with something a bit different for you. No, it's not a video about these big Waukesha engines, because all I know about them is that they're big. I don't know anything else about them. Well, maybe they burn, I was gonna say diesel, but it's natural gas. See, I don't know a whole lot about them. So the video is not about V12s. What I've been doing for the past couple of weeks is some investigation into the rebuildability or the serviceability of a Curtiss-Wright J-65 turbojet out of an A4 Skyhawk. Now, the Curtiss-Wright J-65 has a little bit of an unusual fuel nozzle system. It's different from the usual types that we have. So I'm going to show you the fuel nozzles. Now, in this engine, there are 36 of them. 36 fuel nozzles, and they spray their fuel into what are called walking stick burners. We're going to show you the walking stick burners in a second, but here we're going to take a look at the fuel nozzles. This is all 36 of them. They've been cleaned up a bit, and they're just a simple tube with an open end. Now, for comparison, an engine that is of similar age and similar power is the Arenda Type 14 we've been working on for quite some time. The Arenda Type 14 fuel nozzles, there's 6 of these. And they're these great big showerhead fuel nozzles. Okay, what's the difference? The difference is, these spray their fuel into a hot tube, and what comes out of that tube is fuel vapor. All the other fuel nozzles and all the other engines we've been dealing with since I started making these videos, they use pressure to spray a finely atomized mist. Sometimes there's air blast holes that allow the air to mix in and further atomize the fuel, but their product is a fine mist of fuel droplets rather than an actual vapor of fuel. So the J-65 has, they look like little fuel dribblers, don't they? So let's take a look at what they put their fuel into. Okay, this engine's dirty, it's been run a bit, it's been put away and not been stored properly, but there are the walking stick burners. Each one of those, the J-shaped tubes, they have one of the little fuel nozzles dripping into it, and we're looking from the back of the engine forward. So inside those tube sections, the fuel is vaporized into a vapor, and then it burns in its gaseous state in this large single annular combustor. There we go. There's some dirt and some residue in this combustor, but that's not that unusual. Now, something that might be a bit of interest to those of us who are Canadians is that this engine's combustor and fuel nozzles and walking stick burners look almost exactly like the ones used in the Arenda Iroquois. The Arenda Iroquois was designed with help from the same people, Armstrong Siddeley. This engine is based on an Armstrong Siddeley Sapphire. And if you look at an Arenda Iroquois, which we have one in our shop, the fuel nozzles, the walking stick burners, and the combustor liner look almost exactly like that. It's amazing. A very strong family resemblance. So, what have we learned? That there's always another way of doing things. And here is an example of 6 of these, or 36 of these. Both of these engines, the Arenda 14 and the J-65, make about the same power. The Arenda Type 14 makes 7,200 pounds of thrust. The J-65 makes about 8,000. So they're quite comparable in power level. And the fuel system is very different between each of these two engines. Now, if you're thinking, hey, I think I might have seen that sticker on one of the race boats, well, you'd be right. From the shop at Compression Technology in Fort St. John, thanks for watching.